This is City Lights on WABE Atlanta. The Michael C. Carlos Museum has a new exhibit. African Cosmostellar Arts is one in a trilogy of traveling exhibits from the Smithsonian on Africa's contribution to knowledge. This exhibit takes a look at cultural astronomy on the African continent, how countries scientifically, religiously, and culturally interact with the cosmos. There are more than 70 art pieces from traditional to contemporary. Several of the pieces have video and sound elements. WABE producer Gabby Watts took a tour with the Carlos's African art curator, Amanda Hellman. What we hear next is a description of the gallery in the point of view of these more sound-filled pieces. The first piece kind of sounds like microphone feedback, but really, it's the sound of the sky.
It's by Marcus Neusetter, a South African artist. It's called Chasing Light. It was completed in 2009 and 2010 when Marcus Neusetter went to Norway for an artist residency. He was really excited about seeing the Aurora Borealis, and the entire time that he was there, it was overcast. So he worked with a fellow artist, and they recorded the sound of the Aurora Borealis. They recorded the frequencies. He took that back to South Africa and played it on a speaker. He put a tray of water on top of the speaker, which vibrated with the sound, and then he shot a beam of light through that tray of water. And so you have the sound that he recorded and the visual display that he created. The exhibition African Cosmos is looking at the way in which different cultures on the African continent, from ancient Egypt through traditional African and into contemporary African art, are looking at their relationship to the cosmos. The exhibition is organized into stellar arts, lunar arts, solar arts, and then it's bookended by the art that pertains to the connection between the Earth and the sky. The work consists mostly of pieces from the National Museum of African Arts collection, so the Smithsonian's collection. We have a significant amount from our own collection. We've borrowed several pieces from the various artists like William Kendrich and Marcus Neusetter. There's another video work in here that I definitely recommend checking out. It's by South African artist William Kendrich. So it's kind of looking at Georges Méliès' film noir and kind of looking at the artist and the artist's creative process as similar to a journey to the moon or a journey into space. I really love the Kanaga masks. I think it's really fun to see the Kanaga masks kind of dance along the wall. They sort of look like stick figures. They're masks, you know, worn on the face, and then above the head are two horizontal bands with a vertical band that connects those two. And it's worn every 12 years for a funereal ceremony called a Dhamma ceremony. Deep Survey. It's a collaboration between an artist, Carl Nell, an astrophysicist, and an illustrator. The video that you see, it's data points that have been animated by an illustrator, and it moves you deep into space to the beginning of time and then back out again. And Carl Nell recorded the sound in his backyard of what he envisions deep space would sound like. I think what I'm interested in the viewers recognizing as a curator is seeing traditional African art in this dialogue with ancient art and contemporary art. And I think that that is really important so that we can break out of our mindset that African art is, you know, in this sort of ethnographic present, that it's always been that way and it will always be that way.
That was the Carlos Museum's African arts curator, Amanda Hellman, highlighting some of the pieces in the new exhibit, African Cosmos Stellar Arts. The exhibit is packed with pieces from ancient to contemporary, all from the African continent. The show is on view through June 21st.